Let's face it, Alpha Motion has a lot more, and honestly, way better tools and effects than Final Cut Pro. But some of you may not have Motion, and even if you do, if you need a specific tool or effect for your project, it's kind of a pain in the ass to round trip your clips from Final Cut Pro to Motion and back just for a specific effect. Well, now you don't have to. My friend and fellow YouTuber Dylan Bates has brought over 100 tools and effects available on Motion to Final Cut Pro. So today, we're taking a look at Dylan's extremely useful Motion Tools plugin for Final Cut Pro. When you first download this plugin, the folder comes with all the assets you need. It also comes with some really useful extra information, including a simple video showing you how to install this plugin, as well as a troubleshooting guide in case you have any issues. Once installed into Final Cut Pro, you can find all the Motion Tools in the Effects browser under the Motion Tools category. This plugin comes with over 100 tools and effects nicely organized into categories, making it super simple to find the effect you need. Let's go through a few of these, and I'll try a demo one or two from each category. First up is the basic category. Here, you get some simple but very useful effects. For example, the fade in out effect does exactly what it says it does. When you add this to your clip, you get a nice fade in at the start and a fade out at the end. In the inspector, you get a few controls so you can adjust the speed of the fade and even offset the start and end times of your animation. Another nice effect in this category is the motion path effect. When you add this to your clip, you get these handy on-screen controls for animating motion in your image. For example, if you want to move this logo across the screen, just use the on-screen controls to set the start and end points. Your logo follows the path you defined. What makes this effect better than keyframing, which sucks in Final Cut Pro, is you can adjust the speed of your movement. You can ease in, ease out, accelerate, decelerate, and more for nice smooth motion in your animation. The next category includes what is probably one of my favorite effects in this pack, the overshoot effect. I love using this for titles. You just drag and drop it over your title clip, and you get this cool bounce animation. There's a bunch of parameters you can adjust here to make it look exactly the way you want. It's a simple effect, but an awesome way to animate text. In the blurs category, you'll notice some effects have a plus beside them, like the Gaussian blur effect. This means this effect comes built into Final Cut Pro, but Motion Tools gives you a few extra controls. There's also a few blur effects here you don't get in Final Cut Pro. The gradient blur effect blurs only part of your image, slowly fading out across your frame. With a channel blur effect, you can blur only specific color channels for a very unique look. The borders category also contains a super useful effect not included with Final Cut Pro. While you can add a border around your image in Final Cut Pro, you can only add it around the outside of your frame. If you have a graphic with a transparent background, there's no way to add an outline or a border to it. For that, in Motion Tools, we have the stroke effect. Adding this to your graphic adds a border around your graphic and not your video frame. And there's a lot of parameters you can adjust here to make it look exactly the way you want. In the color category, there's quite a few cool effects you get with this pack. And one of my favorites is color reduce. This lets you take your video clip and reduce the image to a specific number of colors. You just add this to your video clip, select a number of colors, and choose the colors you want to use. Not sure how practical this effect is, but I sure love the way it looks. The distortion category comes with the most effects in this pack. One of my favorites here is the black hole effect. If you add this effect to your text and keyframe it, you get a really cool text animation. Add this effect to your title clip, place your playhead close to the end of your title, set the amount to 0, and add a keyframe. Move about 5 frames ahead, and bring up the amount slider until your text is gone. If we play this back, this effect makes it look like your text is getting sucked into a black hole. Really cool. Let's keep going. The glow category also comes with quite a few effects. My favorites are glint, which adds a nice cool glowing effect to your highlights, and the overdrive effect. This is a pretty extreme look, but depending on your project, might be exactly what you need. Under this, we have a couple key-in tools, which are pretty self-explanatory, and in the miscellaneous category, we get motion blur. We have 3 types, light, medium, and heavy, and I'm still not sure why Apple doesn't just add these to Final Cut Pro. There's no adjustments or anything here. You just pick the amount you want and drag the preset over your clip. Render out your clip, and you get this nice subtle motion blur effect. The sharpened and unsharpened mask effects are pretty self-explanatory too, so let's just move on to the looks category. You get some really cool stuff here, like the edges effect, a posterize effect, and I really like this wavy screen look. I'll skip over the tile category and go straight to another one of my favorite effects, the strobe effect. What this does is it gives you that choppy, low frame rate look. You just add this effect to your clip, and up in the inspector, set your frame rate. So if we set this to 5, it makes it look like your clip was shot at 5 frames per second. It's a bit of a novel effect, but I love using this in my project. Super useful for music videos too. As far as plugins go for Final Cut Pro, this is one of the most useful plugins I've ever used. Dylan did a great job here. And if you're one of the 3 people here who don't know who Dylan Bates is, I'll link his channel in the description below. Go check it out, some amazing Final Cut Pro emotion stuff there. He even did a 2-hour live stream where he explains every single effect you get with this preset. Trust me, this will be the best $25 you'll ever spend on Final Cut Pro. Thanks for watching. Now, go buy this plugin and check out Dylan's channel.